Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. You've all been incredibly patient with all of our wonderful speeches today, but they were well deserved because Bharulata actually is so, so inspirational. But before I talk about Bharulata, I need to talk about her husband. Because I think that he, first of all, he's been a great star with his co-host Rajesh today. But you can see and hear the pride in his voice every time he says, Bharulata. So, and I have the same because I have Ashok. So when Ashok talks about me, I think, I hope, he talks in the same way that you do. But really, what's really, really important is that she's inspired not just women and girls, but men and boys to be able to be educated, to change their own social thinking about girls and women. This isn't just a story of a girl or a woman doing something. It's about society changing its attitude towards women and girls. And that's why we support something so phenomenal as what Bharulata has done. 32 countries, all by yourself. Yes, there were lots of heroes behind you. And those heroes had to be there because without people supporting you, you don't get the sort of gusto to get out and do things. You need people to be able to say, you know what, you can do it and we're with you. However much bravo Bharulata has for herself, ultimately it needs people to say, we're with you. And so all those heroes are wonderful people who believed in her for her to continue to believe in herself. You know, they say a tiger's baby knows they're going to be a tiger. Bharulata knew she was going to be what she is today. Not because of the environment she grew in was telling her she could do it, but the environment she grew in was telling her she couldn't do it. Now, when you challenge environments like you have done, like Srila, who's now left, like I have done, and like many of you have done here, I mean, each one of you who have come and settled in this country have challenged norms to be able to settle in a different country and then contribute in it. It's really important, and I don't know who said it, maybe Srila, that women are not great supporters of women. Fallacy. It's reinforced by men because it's easy to divide people up. Most women I know, if they can't do it themselves, they wish they could. But they don't stop another woman from doing it. They might wish it was them, but they can at least change it for their daughters. But let me give a message to each and every one of you. She's going to do another journey. She's going to write another book. These books, these journeys need to be told out to many more people. And many more people will then be able to change society, because that's what you want to do. Prime Minister Modi wants to change society in India, but we need to change society here too. Because however modern and developed we think we are, trust me, I still go into events where the women sit on one side and the men sit on one side. When it comes to the food serving, the women are expected to serve. So I think for us, what I've gathered, and I've learned a lot, she's years younger than me, but what I've learned from looking at Bharulata and her husband, and this is a team effort, what I've learned is that if people really work together and don't see the conflict of egos and interest, and that her husband is as proud of her as she would be of him, then things can change. Now, we can do that, each and every one of us. But let me say this, it's not just about making it okay for women and girls. Go up there, you men as well, and send out a very clear message. The world will be a much better place if we all actually support each other's missions, both boys, girls, men, women. Because to be quite frank, we can't manage without each other. So 50% of the population has got to support the other 50% if we're going to make any changes. Now, the young lady who's our assembly member who's left, I mean, we're all proud of her. I don't care what her politics is. I'm just proud that she's managed to achieve it. I don't care which part of India Bharulata came from or comes from. I see her as a role model for girls across the world. And the great thing is, I don't think Bharulata sees herself as anybody other than a global person that everybody needs to be inspired with. So for us, she does say she's a guju sometimes, but we won't hold that against her. The important thing is this, that for those of us who have championed the rights of women and girls for a very, very long time, and I had the privilege of being David Cameron's prime ministerial champion for tackling violence against women and girls across the globe, let me tell you, it really does take a lot of effort from all of us to look at what we can do. But doing it doesn't take a lot of effort. Because to be quite frank, all you've got to do is go home today and just think of how you're going to respond to people in your family. That's how simple it is. So I'm going to wish Bharulata well. I'm going to wish her sons well, because her sons will be growing up knowing that the women that come into their lives will be like their mother. And I'm going to wish her husband well, because without him supporting her to the hilt, like I have with my husband, you know, the reason why we're educating tribal girls is not because it makes us feel good, but we believe that those girls will change the societies they live in. And I'm hoping, and our promise to them is we'll educate them, we'll house them, we'll look after them. But their promise to us is that for us, they will make sure they support two girls in their lifetimes. Now, they may support more, but it will have the ripple effect. So I'm hoping that all of you, when you go out from here today, will see this poster girl and say, do you know what? If I've got a daughter or I've got a sister, that's how I'd like her to be. Whether you are a mother, a father, or a brother, or a sister. Because to be quite frank, if we don't celebrate, nobody else will. So for us, we're with you on your journey, you're with us on ours. And for all of us here today, we're extremely proud of you. We look forward to reading your book. And I'm sure you'll sell lots and lots of copies, because all of these people here are going to make sure that each one of them sell at least 10 on each behalf of you. So thank you very much. Now, unfortunately, I'm chair of a thing called the European External Affairs Committee, which is looking at Brexit. I don't know why I'm looking at Bob when I say Brexit. I don't know why. But I've got a lot of papers to read for my committee tomorrow. So please excuse me, but it's been a joy listening to other speakers whilst I've been here today, and of course, being with all of you. Thank you very much indeed.